In this video, we will focus on how primary control is applied in conventional power systems. In detail, we will address the role of the speed governor in primary control. We will see how can the active power balance be restored, and we will look at the equations that are used to mathematically describe the primary control for a system with one and multiple generation units. Primary control is the mechanism to restore the active power balance in a power system. The centrifugal governor or speed governor plays an important role in all levels of the frequency control, including primary control. In a traditional power system, the speed governor adjusts the speed of a machine by regulating the amount of fuel that is supplied to it. To understand this better, let's look at the governor turbine model. The governor features a controller that monitors the rotor speed, which is tied to the grid frequency. The governor is responsible of adjusting the throttle valves of the turbine according to the speed deviations. In this way, it is possible to regulate the injection of fuel, which is gas in the case of a gas turbine, or steam in the case of steam turbines. Through this mechanism, it is possible to regulate the mechanical torque applied to the shaft, and therefore regulate the output electric power. The speed governor can be set with a frequency power characteristic in order to help the system restore the power balance. The frequency power characteristic, or droop, has a negative slope. You can observe this on the screen. As you can see, the power increases as the frequency decreases. The droop is the frequency drop in per unit of the rated frequency when the active power output of the generator rises from no load to full load. It can be mathematically described by the equation on your screen. The droop of a generator, I, is defined as the ratio of the frequency change to the corresponding change in active power output provided by the same generator. Note that the power change is given as the percentage of the initial power production, while the frequency change is given as the percentage of the nominal rated frequency. The rated frequency corresponds to the grid frequency, 50 Hz or 60 Hz, depending on the country. Here in the Netherlands, the grid frequency is 50 Hz, for example. In control theory, primary control corresponds to an example of proportional control, where the droop is considered a gain. According to ENSO-E, the European Network of Transmission System Operators for Electricity, the droop coefficient of generators must be between 2 and 5%, where all generators should be able to vary 1.5% of the nominal power in order to support primary frequency control. Let's have a look at a numerical example. So consider that due to a change in the load, a system suddenly needs to supply an additional 2% from its rated load of 300 megawatts, meaning 6 megawatts. The droop coefficient is of 2%. If the frequency was at a rated 50 Hz, what would be the new system frequency? Rearranging the droop equation and substituting with the values, we can see that the new system frequency is 49.98 Hz. For a multi-generator system, the network power frequency characteristic given by lambda is determined by the droop and the nominal rated power of all generators in the system. In this case, a change in active power consumption is met by all generators, given as the combination of all droops, as shown in the equation. The network power frequency characteristic lambda is the negative of the change of power in the system divided by the change in frequency of the system. The droop must be fairly evenly spread in the network so that, for example, if higher power generation is required due to an increase in the load, the power can flow from the different parts of the network to prevent overloads in parts of the system. It is important to note that after primary control takes place, the power balance is restored at a lower or a higher frequency, which is not a desirable operation condition. We want to reestablish the frequency as close as possible to 50 Hz or 60 Hz to avoid damages to equipment and loads, but that is done with a different mechanism. So let's now sum up. In this video, we looked at how primary control is performed in traditional power systems. We looked at how the speed governor worked and at the mathematical description of the primary control mechanism for single and multiple generator units. We learned that after primary control is applied, the power balance of the system is restored, however, under a different frequency. For this reason, after primary control has taken place, another mechanism is still necessary to restore the frequency back to its reference value. In the next video, we're going to talk about this mechanism.